Hello friends, welcome to Astro Intelligence videos. Today we are going to discuss a subject which in my opinion is very less talked about, very less researched, very less taught, and you won't surprise if I say that this subject has found very less mention in our Vedic Shastras, that is Brihad Parashar Hora Shastra. Maharishi Parashar mentioned this subject in the textbook in few of the mantras, but never talked about in detail. So friends, first of all, I should over this suspense. The subject is Vakri planets or retrogression. As I have already told you that this subject, in my opinion, is under-researched. So, in this video, we will try to make this subject very simple, very much accessible to you, and very much clearer to you, so that you won't find much problem getting details from this Vakri planets or retrograde planets. But we will start first with the concept, what is actual retrogression as per Vedic Shastras. So friends, we will move on to the presentation by which I'll be clarifying. Friends, I think the presentation is clear to you that this is regarding retrograde planets or Vakri Grahas. As you see that this shloka or the mantra is taken from Brihad Parashar Hora Shastra chapter 21. What does it say? It says, Vakranu Vakra Vikla Manda Mandtara Sama Chara Cha Ati Chara Cheti Graha Nam Ashtadha Gati. Friends, this is the actual mantra from which the concept of Vakri or retrogression is taken. And as you can see from this mantra that this pertains to the motion of the planet. Now we will move on to the actual presentation. Vakri Grahas or retrograde planets. First of all, I have put a sign of question mark. As the presentation progresses, you will come to know the meaning of this question mark. The Sanskrit name mentioned in text for retrograde is Vakra. Anywhere no mention about Vakri is there. And what does this Vakra means? Vakra means curve. That means the circle or the elliptic circle which is taken by the planet is known as Vakra. So why it is Vakra? When curves are used, many a times twisting can take place. Friends, you should come to know that Vakra is a curve. And when curves are multiplied or present in up or down fashion, then twisting can take place. And in negative sense, Vakra means dishonest. But it is not at all reverse motion as told by the word retrogression. It is a Western thought, but it is not as per Vedic Shastras. So friends, here a contradiction is there between our Vedic Jyotish and Western Jyotish. Because in our texts, the word used is Vakra, and Vakra means curve, or maximum what you can get from the meaning of Vakra, that twisting. No doubt there are different meanings, but one thing is there that this is Vakra. First of all, we should be clear that this is not Vakri. This is Vakra. And next point, that Vakra Rekha or Vakra Asan. Friends, there can be two types of lines. One is simple line and other is Vakra line. Simple means Saral line. Saral Rekha and Vakra Rekha. Saral Rekha is a simple line and Vakra Rekha is a curvy line. Or in other words, you can say it is a curve. So, Vakra means a curve. And if we want to understand Vakra Asana in detail, that is done in yoga. That means twisting the body from back to front is done. And by doing this, what we get? Usually this asana is done to strengthen the spine and make our body flexible. Now, I will make you understand what is the actual meaning of this retrogression or the actual word, this Vakra. As you see in this picture, that this yellow circle is your sun. And our native earth is demonstrated as a single line. This is sun and we are here on this earth. And the dotted line says that this is the normal axis of the planet. But when it is a Vakra, that means the curve is enhanced. More curvature is there. That means this is a Vakri planet, or you can say this is a retrogressed planet. And what we get out of this curve? I will make you understand by these two examples of Jupiter and Saturn. As you very well see, suppose Saturn in its normal motion, then definitely it will be closer to your Earth. But once it is Vakri, that means it has gone far away from your Earth. And simultaneously, this thing happens with Saturn also, or even with every planet which undergoes the Vakra motion. And what does it give? It gives the malefic Saturn becomes less malefic as it is more distant from the earth. So, in a way, it is good. Now, I will make it clearer to you. Suppose your sun Saturn is here. Definitely, it will be more closer to you. That means more closer to earth. Once the Saturn goes away from you, that means the maleficence or the karkatvas or the expression of Saturn is diminished because of the distance. When it is nearer to you, definitely the effect will be more. When it goes away from you, the effect will be less. So, indirectly, maleficence decreases, and indirectly we can say that it becomes slightly good. So, this retrogression or the process becomes good for malefic planets. Now we will take the example of benefic planets. As you see, benefic Jupiter becomes less benefic as it goes away. So it is not good. Now understand this thing, that when Jupiter was in its normal motion, it is quite closer to your Earth. So definitely, the potential of the effect coming from or the expression coming from Jupiter will be more. And when it goes away from you, from the earth, definitely that expression will be diminished or it will be less. So, we can say this thing, that the Vakra effect on benefic planets, it is not good. Now, we will take up some academic points. As I have already told you that this Vakra is a curve. So definitely, the arc size is enhanced. Planet goes away from Sun. And how much arc difference is there? Mars, in its normal motion, it is 164. And it can go up to 196 degrees. So that means this much effect of curvature is enhanced. the arc size is enhanced from 164 to 196 degrees. And for Venus, it is 163 to 197. For Mercury, it is 144 to 216. For Jupiter, 130 to 230 degrees. And for Saturn, it is 115 to 245. As the planet is distant, that means the retrogression also enhances. Here, it is less degrees. Here, it is almost 130 degrees. So that means the curvature side or the arc distance from the sun increases with the process of being Vakri or this retrogression. Now, what does it say? Saturn retrogrades for 140 days and remains stationary 5 days before and after. These are the stats. You should note down these stats. That Saturn retrogrades for 140 days and remains stationary 5 days before and 5 days after. Jupiter retrogrades for 120 days and is stationary 5 days before and after. Mars retrogrades for 80 days and is stationary 3 days to 4 days before and after. Venus is retrograde for 42 days and is stationary approximately 2 days before and after. Mercury retrogrades for 24 days and it is stationary 1 day before and after. These are the normal dasha periods of retrogression for different planets or the 5 planets which can become retrograde. Actually, till now I am using the word retrograde, but you will come to know that this is not a proper word. The motive of Vakra planet is to be flexible. What is the motive of this retrogression? What we get out of the enhanced curvature? That means the motive of Vakra planet or the enhanced curvature is to be flexible. Note down this thing, that flexibility increases with Vakra Asana, so we can say that this is the same effect which is passed on for the enhanced curvature of the planets also. To twist things around, this is an observation which comes out of that Vakra effect. To make them unclear, to give indifferent and indirect expression. Note down these points, that the Vakra planet or when the curvature is enhanced, then what does effect it gives? It gives flexibility to the strength. It gives twisting around. It makes the results of that planet or the expression of that planet unclear. And it is capable of giving indirect and indifferent results. In this process, they strengthen themselves and flexibly adapt themselves to different results. When this process of being Vakra is on negative side, then they can be dishonest, crooked thinkers who can twist things around. These Vakra or retrograde planets can impart positive or negative potential. Friends, this is a normal thing that every planet, whether it is Vakra or whether it is in normal motion, that means they can give or they can impart two results, that is good and bad. And simultaneously, Vakra planets are also capable of giving positive and negative potential, but express themselves in good or bad phases for the natives based on their free will. Now, I want to make this point clearer to you that planets don't give results of their own. The results are there inside it. The characters belong to that planet. But all the characters cannot be imparted to each and every individual. Friends, I can here quote the example of Jupiter. As you know, Jupiter has knowledge, but definitely it has got knowledge of approximately 1000 subjects, 2000 subjects or even more. But out of these 1000 or 2000 subjects, the native is capable of getting 3, 4, 5, 10 subjects at the most. So, why this selective process is there? Is the planet is giving the selective characters, or are we getting the selective results? Friends, here I will tell you that this selection, this quality of selection, this power of selection is given to the human beings by the divine God. And this is known as our free will. We can accept 5 subjects from Jupiter. We can accept 10 subjects from Jupiter, but definitely this selection process is in our hands. So we can clearly say this thing that planets don't give results. Actually, we accept those results. And how we accept those results, this depends upon the placement of the planet and the strength of the planet. Rishi Parashar is very, very intelligent person because he has given us this clear instruction that the planets can give us good or bad results, but actually it is for us to get those results from those planets. I think this thing is clearer to you. Now, Rahu and Ketu, the imaginary nodes of the moon, are described as reverse motion planets. So they can be called retro motion planets. Friends, I want to make some stress on this point. First of all, I will read out this point to you, then I will discuss this point. Rahu and Ketu, the imaginary nodes of the moon, are described as reverse motion planets. So they can be called retro motion planets. But still, they cannot be termed as retrograde because they are not inferior in degrees or strength. So the terminology needs to be changed. Here, I want to emphasize my thought process to you that no doubt Rahu and Ketu, they are told to us by Maharishi Parashar that these are the imaginary nodes of the moon. They are the north node and the south node, and their motion is always reverse. Here they have used this word reverse motion, so they can be called retro motioned planets. But the word used by the Western astrologer, and that word is now universally acceptable, that these planets are retrograde planets. But friends, on one side we say that planets gain in strength when curvature is enhanced. Nowhere it is mentioned that the strength of the Vakri planets or the enhanced curvature planets decreases. So why it is called retrograde? Retrograde means that strength of the planet decreases. But here the contradiction arises. But the strength of planets always increase with the retrogression, with the enhanced curvature, or with the Vakra process. So I think there is need for change of this terminology, which is given as retrogression or retrograde planets for these 5 planets. Next, Rahu and Ketu expresses their potential in a completely indifferent manner and can be astonishingly innovative and make humans capable of achieving so much heights that they never thought of. So, the enhanced strength of the planets given by this Vakra process is astonishingly high, astonishingly innovative. So, you can be surprised with the results given by those Vakra planets. Rahu and Ketu with their reverse motion can actually express the extent of moon's imagination, which can in turn become the sole reason of one's transformation in this life. Friends, this is a very important point. And this process of moon's progression, moon's imagination, and the process of telling the imaginary Rahu Ketu to us by Maharishis is actually a very, very important. I have already made it clear in my previous videos to you that what is Rahu and Ketu. I have clearly told you that Rahu and Ketu are just the projection of your moon. And moon, you know, that is the actual tool by which you can go all out getting those material things, those desires, or you can go inside you through Ketu by doing meditation or undergoing spiritual path. So this is a very, very important point. Why this Rahu and Ketu, by their reverse motion, first they become strong, then they enhances the moon's imagination. That is why Rahu and Ketu forms the most importantly talked about energy axis. Rahu and Ketu makes the energy axis, and because of their reverse motion, this energy axis becomes the most important axis of your horoscope. That is as simple as that. And in our videos for transformative astrology, we made a point to clearly tell you that this Rahu Ketu axis, or this Rahu Ketu energy axis, is capable of giving transformation in one's life. Next, Sun and Moon never takes reverse motion and expresses their potential being the ruler of day and night. This thing is self-explanatory, as Sun is the ruler of day and Moon is the ruler of night. But here I want to make some clarifications to you. Friends, you know, what is Sun? Sun is the actual light source. Sun is the light which is known as the Jyoti, on which our Jyoti Shastra is formed. The actual Jyoti is coming from that Sun. And Moon receives that energy, receives that light from the Sun and reflects it during night. So Sun is your soul and Moon is your Man. Man reflects that light which is absorbed from the Sun, and through your Moon you are capable of undergoing or doing most of the works which are known as karmas. Next point, Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus and Saturn are other illuminating bodies which expresses their potential by providing human beings with five material elements with which we all are made up of. Friends, you know that total universe is material. It is made up of certain things. And what are those certain things? They are the five Panch Mahabhutas, five basic elements. And these five planets are responsible for giving those five elements to that creation process through which this universe was made and through which our bodies are made. Our bodies are physical in nature. This universe is physical in nature, but the materials being used for this creation comes through Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus and Saturn. Actually, friends, these materials are not directly coming from them, but Rishis used these names to make us understand that five Panch Mahabhutas are there, and through their names, this concept becomes clearer to us. So now, these five elements expresses as giver and controller of material things, which becomes the actual reality of the existence, life existence. Actually, life is physical. No doubt we know that the living thing in that life process is your soul. But definitely, life is material. So we cannot separate this process of spirituality and materialism. They are interlinked. And these five elements, they give their expression as givers of those material desires and control those material desires also. So that means the actual reality of life existence. Vedic astrology classics say that retrograde planets are strong. The expression or the quality of planet changes with the when its motion changes. Retrograde planets are either closest to the earth or they move away because of the curvy path. But one thing is certain, that their impact on the individual is strongest. So friends, here we should be clear on this thing, that the process of Vakra or the process of so-called retrogression imparts strength to that planet. That planet becomes strong, that planet becomes flexible, that planet is capable of giving astonishingly innovative, strong results. Retrogression can express its potential effect in the natal chart and in the transit. Friends, now you should understand this thing, that one, first, your natal chart is one thing, that it belongs to you only, but you are living in a collective consciousness which is known as this universe or multiverse. There, planets are there. They are getting effect from other suns, from other galaxies. And the process of retrogression takes place there also. So, whenever you get this Vakra process in your natal chart, it is going to affect you only. But whenever the retrogression process or this Vakra process is there in the multiverse, in the universe, it is going to make an impact on each and every individual on this earth. Natives having retrograde planets usually find it difficult to control the energy expression of that planet. Friends, I have already told to you that planets, whether it is retrograde or they are in simple motion, they give certain results. But the Vakra planets, they find it difficult to control this energy expression. They are either overexpressive or being in denial of their positive qualities. You can get these two results. They can overexpress themselves or they can deny these things. So, effort should be made to know the actual energy potential of that planet and its motive in life. Friends, actually, this is the motive of astrology or the Shastra which was given to us by Maharishi Parashar, that we should know the energy potential of this soul. We should know the energy potential of the planet. We should know the extent by which we can receive the potential from that planet. This is the motive of Vedic Jyotish. Vakri planets in transit can influence everyone, whether we have them in our chart or not. Very knowledgeable positive persons can suddenly change and become a negative seer under the influence of Vakri Jupiter. Now the example of Jupiter is taken to make you understand that how much effect a Vakra planet can give you. In transit also, it can affect each and every individual, but in your natal chart, it is going to affect you only. And what is that effect? It can affect, if we take the example of Jupiter, that it can bring a negative searing pattern, negative thought pattern, negative knowledge pattern in a positive person. Or a malefic effect coming from the planet like Saturn can give you positive impact. So, what is the conclusion we get from this presentation? We can say with clarity that Vakri planets are not always bad, but they are strong in expression. That their expression increases, but how much effect we receive, that depends and varies from person to person. But the good or bad expression is based on their placement in the chart. This is the very important thing from which you can derive results. That this selection process is basically with us. This remote control is with us. How? First of all, we should know the placement of the planet. We should know the strength of the planet. We should know the energy emanated or the energy potential of the planet. And we should correspond this energy potential with the energy potential of the soul by which it can receive that energy potential from that vakra process or from that enhanced energy level. So this subject is a very, very important subject, but I think it has to be dealt with some importance. So by this presentation, I wanted to make this process clearer to you. And in my opinion, the process will be more clearer to you, more simpler to you, and it will make you capable of understanding the process of Vakra. But my humble submission to all of the listeners, the thinkers, and the students of astrology, that they should rethink the name given to Vakra planets. I think they should change the name from retrograde to reverse motion planets. Thank you very much, friends.